Today, I stood with Jake. Jake is a student at a private school here in St. Louis. He plays football, and he came out this fall. And Westboro Baptist Church, who I typically don't give the time of day, decided to protest him. They decided to protest not only Jake, but the whole what they would call gay agenda that's ruining the United States and is causing the wrath of God to come down on the country. Like I said, I don't give them much attention. However, there are a couple reasons why I went today. One, Jake's mom is a specialist at my children's school, and I wanted to support her. We have an anti-racist, anti-bias framework that I helped to develop, and she's been on board since day one. And so I wanted to show her the same sort of support that she's shown the school and the children and my work. I know what it's like to have your child targeted, but I really have no idea what it's like when it's on such a big stage. And second, a graduate student in my program asked for us to attend. I wanted to support him. Little did I know, half of the first year students and several advanced students also attended. Add to that the clinic director and her partner and me and mine. We were a solid group of 10 folks, and it was nice to be at the event with people that I work with. It's not every day that you're at a protest with people you see walking down the hall at your workplace. I appreciated that, and I want to contribute to that sort of community in our program. But there are a few things that I've been thinking about since going to the protest. One, the lack of public space around this private school. It's in a wealthy area of the county, and while there was green space in the form of two big country clubs around the school, there was nowhere to park. No public spaces, no parks, no street parking. So we took our chances at a monastery, hoping the monks wouldn't tow us. We were lucky, they didn't. But I was just struck by that difference between urban and suburban living. And secondly, the police at this predominantly white protest were really friendly. They were facilitating and had kind words for the protesters, which is very different than the predominantly black protests of Fight for 15 or Movement for Black Lives. And I wanna just be clear that those are disparate experiences, both groups protesting and exercising their First Amendment rights. But it feels very different to be a protester in those different spaces. So those are a few things that are swirling around in my head since going to the event. So my decision to go today was, like I said, to support Jake, his mom, my graduate student, and the fact that love trumps hate, right? Part of my reservations about today was that Pride STL was the organization that called the event. They have a history of not acknowledging intersectionality, a history of not having representation, and actually some mistreatment of people of color, black, queer, and trans folks in particular. And I felt some type of way about going to the event. And I'm pushing myself this year to hold people in their contradictions and not be so quick to throw people or organizations away just because I am frustrated or I think that they did something wrong in the past, or there might have been problematic leadership. I want to be open to allowing people to grow and change and learn from their mistakes. And I want to be held in my mistakes and my contradictions. So I went today in that spirit. And it's not necessarily asking for reciprocity, but I sure hope for it. I hope that people come out and stand for me and people who look like me, even if we don't share a social identity or we aren't in community with each other, that protests are a beautiful place to create community. I know that it's hard to make our movements intersectional. Intersectional movements take work, and they take talking to each other, telling hard truths, and speaking truth to power. But I think it's worth trying. It's not the way that we've done things in St. Louis. I hope it's the way that we can try to do things in the future. And so it's for those reasons that I went, and for those reasons that I stand with Jake, and it's for those reasons that I commit to standing for others. So what are your thoughts? How would you respond if Westboro Baptist Church came to your town, or how did you respond? What do you think about being willing to hold people in their contradictions rather than throw them in the trash because they made you angry or did something that you know was wrong? So give me your thoughts in the comments. And if you stand with Jake, like and share, and let's continue to stand with each other.